The surgery for liver tumor totally depends on the biology of the liver tumor. There are two main categories of liver tumor. One is so-called primary liver cancer, which include hepatocellular carcinoma or intrahepatic cholangiocarcinoma. The second category is so-called metastatic liver cancer. The main source for those metastases is from colorectal cancer. Many other cancers can also metastasize to liver. So it depends on the biology. We'll make appropriate recommendation for surgical resection. For primary liver cancer, if the tumor is only located in the liver with no other distant metastases, then we consider the anatomy of the tumor. If the tumor is away from the major vessels, if the future liver remnant is enough to support the patient's life, we'll offer them surgical resection. For metastatic liver cancer, the main concern is we want to make sure they don't have extensive extrahepatic disease. And I also want to make sure they get adequate adjuvant chemotherapy or radiation therapy or interventional radiology therapy before any surgical options is offered. Then if the patient is a candidate for surgery, then we consider their liver anatomy to make appropriate decisions. For those patients who could be a candidate for liver surgery, we can potentially offer either laparoscopic or robotic assisted liver resection. The main consideration to make this kind of a surgical decision is they got to have favorable anatomy, which means that liver tumor cannot be too close to the main vessels in the liver. And we also want to make sure they don't have extensive previous liver surgery, which will be really challenging for minimally invasive liver surgery. The benefit of minimally invasive liver surgery is very obvious. From outside, those patients don't have long scar. They only have a few small holes for the minimally invasive surgery. From the medical standpoint, those patients in general recover quicker, less stay in the hospital, less requirement for pain medication, and in the long run, they have less chance for incisional hernia and obviously less chance for bowel obstruction or anything related to intra-abdominal scar formation. The ideal candidate for minimally invasive liver surgery will be a patient who can tolerate general anesthesia, which is a requirement for minimally invasive surgery. The other consideration is this patient, the tumor, got to have very favorable anatomy away from the major vessels. It's very challenging to do minimally invasive surgery for those tumors who are really close to the hepatic vein or portal vein or any major vessels. The main benefit to approach those patients in a multidisciplinary scenario is to offer them the best treatment plan. Surgery is not the only option for those patients. Some patients may benefit from neoadjuvant chemotherapy or even benefit from transarterial chemoembolization, which is done by interventional radiologists here at Johns Hopkins. Those interventional radiologists, they are very experienced. They can perform very technically challenging procedure, which cannot be done at any other hospital. The bottom line is we want to offer those patients facing a liver tumor the best possible treatment plan.